Hey, hi everyone, how are you doing?
Alright.
So in this session, we will discuss how to reverse a number. Alright. So let me explain the problem statement first. So let's say if the input is a number, let's say 1, 2, 3, 4. So your program should give the output as 4, 3, 2, 1. Just the reverse of the given input number. I hope the problem statement is clear now. Let's see how we can write a Java program to achieve this task. So I have created a simple Java class reverse number and a simple public static void main. So let's write a method right here. So public int, return type would be int because I would like to return the result from my method. So public int reverse number, let's say the name of the method. Okay, and it will accept a parameter as int number, and I'll add the return statement at the last. So this is the basic structure of a method, Java method. Okay, so I'll take one variable int result, let's say, and result I would like to return from the method. Okay, so I'll take one variable result, and that result I will be returning from the method. So let's say int result, and this I'll be returning from my method. Okay. So far so good. Okay, so before writing the program, let me explain few things to you. Let's say if I want to reverse this number 1 2 3 4, first of all I would need the last number 4, right? I will fetch 3, then I will fetch 2 and then 1, and I will write somewhere, right? The idea is, from the given input number, I have to extract or fetch or retrieve the last number 4, and that would become my first number in my result variable. Then I will extract 3, and then it would become second number or the second digit of my output number. Okay, now the question comes, how can I get the last number from a given input number, right? So let's forget about this reverse method first. Let me explain you how we can get the last number first. So in the system.println, right here I'll be writing, let's say 1 2 3 4, which is our given input number, and if I use this modulo operator, and if I try to get the remainder, which means if we divide any given number by 10, the remainder will be the last number. So let me show you the demo. So this is very important. This is the critical logic of this whole solution, that you have to use this modulus operator, which will give us the remainder when we divide a given number by 10. So let me run this. And in the console, you would see, okay, if any given number, for example, 1, 2, 3, 4, if I do modulo of that, modulus, I get the last number 4. So this is the logic I'll be using. Let's say if the number is, let's say, 5, 6, 7, 4, 3, for example, okay. And if I use this remainder, if I divide this number 5743 by 10, the remainder would be 3. So if I run again, I would get 3 as an output. Let me run again. Here you go. I got the 3. Okay. And one more thing, if I use the divide operator, if I divide any given number by 10, in this case, let's see what we get. Which means the last part is got removed and we got the 574. And if I, let's say, if I divide 574 divided by 10, the simple mathematical operations, I'm getting 57, one more got removed. If I divide 57 by 10, let's run again, I got 5. Okay. Well, I hope now you have understood the importance of modulus operator and the divide operator. By modulus operator, that percentage sign, we get the last remainder, we get the last digit, because we are dividing the given number by 10 and we are getting the remainder. And if we divide by 10 only, we get the last part removed. Okay. So let's try to implement this logic into our method. So what essentially I'm gonna do is, so I'll use, and I'll make sure in two lines we will write the logic. So in two lines we will reverse the given number, our program will be done. So int result is equal to result into 10 plus, here I'll be using the modulus operator, so num divided by, in fact, num modulo 10, right? And here I have already initialized, so no need to initialize again. And I'll keep on decreasing the number by, so I'll divide by 10. And this I want to do because if we keep on dividing a number, so if the number is, let's say, 1, 2, 3, 4, if we keep on dividing, because this will execute one time only, right? Num divided by 10, we will get 1, 2, 3, but we want to reverse the whole digit of the given number, so we have to put a while loop in that. So I'll use one while loop. While num is greater than 0, keep on repeating this operation. That's it, we are done. So this is a simple program how to reverse a given number. I'll execute this program now, and after that I'll explain one more time what essentially I have done here. So let me make this number as this method as a static, so that I can call without creating the object in the class itself. So reverse number. So in herein I will call in the main method. So let's say I want to reverse a number 1, 2, 3, 4, for example. Okay. I'm just calling in the system.out.println, which means we'll get the output in our console window. So let's our program now. So control will call this method, reverse number 1, 2, 3, 4. So this 1, 2, 3, 4 will go here as an argument, and then this logic will happen and we will get the result, and I'm just returning the result to the method, to the place where this method is called. Okay, so let me execute this program, then I'll explain one more time what is the logic here I have applied to reverse a number. So if the input is 1, 2, 3, 4, I'm getting the output as 4, 3, 2, 1, which is expected result. Let's say I want to reverse any other number. So this program should be generic. Let's say I enter some random number. Okay. Our program should also work. So the given input number is 6, 7, 8, 3, 4. So we should get the output in the reverse order 4, 3, 8, 7, 6. Let's execute. Here you go. we got the output as 43876. So it will work with any number. So let's say this time I'm entering 567. Let's execute again, and we should see the output as 765, right? Which means our code is working. So let me explain what essentially I have done. So I'm using while loop because here I keep on dividing the given number, input number, by 10. If you keep on dividing any given number by 10, at the end we will get the 0 as a result, and that we don't want. So because we want that our program should keep on continue 4 times, this loop should continue 4 times if the digits in the given input number is 4. If digits are 1, 2, 3, then our while loop should work 3 times. So to limit the execution of while loop, we have given one condition. Okay, execute these two lines as long as the given input number is greater than 0. Here I am keep on dividing the given number, num is equal to num by 10. Here I am fetching. So as I discussed in the beginning of the session, if I use modulus operator, it gives the remainder, the last digit. So first time this result is 0, 0 into 10 will be 0. If I divide 1, 2, 3 by, if I do the remainder or modulo by 10, I will get 4. So initially result variable will contain 4. In second iteration, the number will become 1, 2, 3. And again, if I use the modulo, then we will get the 3. And then we are multiplying the result every time into 10. And keep on, and after multiplying the number by 10, we are adding again to the modulo operator. So result is equal to result into 10 plus modulo. So now the question comes, why into 10? Because here we are dividing by 10 every time we are decreasing the number. So to decrease the numbers, or to decrease the numbers, we divide by 10. And again, when we are generating the result, so we have to keep on appending the numbers, right? So that's why every time we are multiplying by 10, so that this become 4000, this become 300, and this become 2, and this become 1. All right, so I think this is a pretty simple program to reverse a number. And this is the most frequently programming interview question, because it checks your programming logic as well as mathematical skills as well. I hope you like the solution of this program. And that's what I wanted to discuss in this session today. Thank you so much.